I've taken way too long to make this video because I was scared. These panels, they've been keeping me up at night. But before we talk about why it's the bottleneck, let's focus on why everything else is so amazing. This case is the perfect example of what flow-through GPUs can do. Sandwich cases are the most popular small form factor format, but flow-through coolers have flipped the script. They dump all their heat into the metal spine right behind where the CPU is. Even with great ventilation, that spine still is going to get really hot and radiate constantly. The Skyreach 5 Mini avoids all of that. It exhausts 100% of the GPU's hot air straight out the side, and it doesn't even need any extra fans to do it. That means it can run quieter than even the best cooled sandwich cases. Free performance. I have a 5090 Founders Edition and a 9800X3D stuffed into this prototype Skyreach 5 Mini, and by the way, this is with stock power supply cables. I wanted a normal build, just stick on cable tie mounts. It's designed to look this clean and be easy to do yourself. But even still, a mainstream case needs side panels. I'll absolutely sell performance blow-through panels, and I fully expect a lot of you to run open air because it looks amazing, and silence, it's addictive. But can you imagine the hate I would get if the stock panels were bad? So I turned to mesh, and after a year of research, I remembered why it wasn't going to work. Too restrictive, too flimsy, too many problems. But Encase had a solution. They found a manufacturer doing something wild. They start with a thick plate and they squish it down, in this case to 2 millimeters thickness. The result is a piece that has a stiffness and mass of a much thicker sheet even after it's perforated. It's basically forged. I haven't seen anything else like it in the PC case world. Eric was here last week helping put the finishing touches on this build, and even he was surprised how solid it felt.
No. It's not moving.
No.
Like, it feels like a piece of carbon fiber.
But all that means nothing if it doesn't work. So I loaded up Indiana Jones and the Great Circle, because nothing, not even synthetics, hits the 5090 harder. It's well optimized, but has every lever and switch imaginable, and was clearly built to scale into future GPUs. With every form of ray tracing on, including hair, the 5090 crushes it with 60 natural frames every second on most maps. For testing, I picked an area where it couldn't hit 60 FPS, plotted a 5-minute course I could reload into, and then captured multiple passes using CapFrameX and HWinfo.
Money is always welcome here.
I kept it simple. Number one, a run with no side panels on. Number two, a run with an intake panel on, but the exhaust off. And three, both side panels on. Three notes for testing methodology. Room temperature was stable, AC blasting, cool day. The 5090 is a 2-slot card, but the Skyreach 5 Mini is a 3-slot case. So the intake sits far enough from the panel that it doesn't change fan timbre or restrict airflow in my unpublished tests. And everything was measured at part temperature after 20 minutes of heat soak. Cold numbers are a lie, and this has to be taken into consideration. Here's what we found. With the panels off, the 5090 sat at 72 degrees Celsius average. With the intake panel on and the exhaust open, 75 degrees Celsius. And with both panels installed, the supposed worst case, it only went up to 80 Celsius on average. That's an 8-degree spread from completely naked to fully enclosed on a 600-watt GPU inside of a console case. That is ridiculous in the best way. The CPU, well, barely moved at all, 67 to 72 degrees Celsius, pretty much an irrelevant difference. But the big one, the GPU never dropped out of the 99 to 100% load limit. The way that I'm reading the graph says no throttling, no weird dips, no stutters. CatFrameX reports 100% smoothness on all three runs. I want to be sure though, so I'm uploading the results as well as the HWinfo data and putting them in the description for you to interpret for yourself. So if you're wondering like I was whether the panels choke the GPU and it collapses under its own heat threshold, no. Everything works as was planned, but not necessarily as expected.
Stop, drop, and roll.
A little piece of physical evidence, the exhaust panel gets very hot, 60 degrees Celsius. Now, that seems like a bad thing until you measure the temperature of the GPU fins and it matches with the panel off. That is what you want to see, the GPU shedding the 600 watts. But here's the real reason people still might run with the panels off or buy performance panels, and it has to do with not performance, but sound. Okay, fans are at basically 100% here, and we're at a noisy part of the room, right? Because this is where the exhaust is hitting that panel. And we're just gonna sit here and listen to it. I am exactly 3 feet away from the system right now. Excuse my messy room here, but I am now about 5 feet away from the console. Here I am, 3 feet away from the S5M as before. Okay, we have both panels off on the S5M, and it sounds so nice it could be white noise. I'm not even kidding. And you can't hear it at all with the TV speakers on. Oops.
All right, good guy, ready to dance?
Now me, I'm actually extremely happy with these results, and it's a huge weight lifted off my shoulders. People running this combo in the right mindset are gonna be very happy, especially if they're taking their hardware from another case and putting it into this one. You can hear and feel the difference. But I'd be lying if I said I wasn't nervous, because we all know how the internet works. Any measurable difference between the panels off and panels on invites outrage, doom, accusations of greed as I try to sell DLC performance panels. A reviewer looking for a spicy thumbnail could twist it into something that it just isn't. But I can't let the maybe stop me. My job is to be realistic, to set expectations, to protect the Skyreach legacy, to design something that I would use and be proud of. These panels are beautiful. They hide mismatched parts so you can choose hardware based on price and performance, not color or flare. They're durable. They keep little fingers and claws out. They're easy to clean, they reduce turbulence, and if you don't like them, the case looks fine without them. Again, we're gonna offer so many options, carbon fiber, acrylic, exotic hardwoods, as we always have done over the past 15 years of Not From Concentrate. I know you have more questions still, but we have more Skyreach 5 mini builds coming. I hope that this one unlocks another piece of the puzzle, and that is performance and what to expect. Special thanks to Akari. He's the guy that sent all these parts in, and I'm so grateful. As a big thank you, he's getting the very first Skyreach mini, this one. And man, you deserve it. I also want to thank Eric for driving down and helping tune it and spending time with me. Really appreciate you, brother. We played a lot of games LAN party style on this computer, and they were never a single issue. It was performing awesome. We also planned our next major Skyreach 5 mini mod, and it's pretty neat. I think you're gonna like it. All right, until next time, guys. Peace.